Hello guys, how are you doing? Welcome back. In this episode, we are going to see how to place DAWs in our project and how we can load DAWs into our project as well. Now, this is the previous work we did on how to make a wall and trace a PNG or a GPG image in our software. And as well, you can trace an AutoCAD file. You can load AutoCAD file and scale it as well and place it as well as same thing as we did for the PNG. Now, for me to load my to place my doors, I need to check my elevation if they are well organized or if the wall are well placed. Yeah, everything are in order where I wanted them to be. So I can go back to my natural ground level. Now placing my floor, my doors here, go to architecture, then we have door. So have either you go for the command DR. Now you'll be tempted to place your wall on your floor plan on your natural ground level, but you are supposed to place them on floor instead of natural ground level. That is not a problem, but you need to know where the doors are placed in this design. But you can see that we cannot actually see or see because there are some places that are covered with our wall. So go to this side, this cube under this visibility style. You see that it's hidden line, click on it. It will show you the graphic display option, which one to pick and which one to go for. So I'm going to make a quick tutorial on how to make a graphic display, but that one is going to be on a presentation. If you want to make a presentation setting, then we are going to make I'm going to talk about this graphic display option setting. Now go for your wireframe, click on it. Now you can see that my plan has become transparent, so I can place my door. Now the door I have picked is 900 mm door, so try is okay. I can place it like so. Yeah, I have door here. Now you can change the direction of the door before placement or after placement by clicking the space bar. You're going to change the direction, but the door I'm supposed to press there is 700 millimeter, which is 700 mm door. Click on 700 and then space bar to change the direction. And I have a door here. I'm supposed to have a door here, and this wall is not supposed to be here. Yeah, so I have a closet here, WA, then make this. Yeah, have something like this, and then this wall you can adjust it to this side. Now I can place my door 900 or 800, whichever I want to place, and place it like so. I need a door here, click. I need a door here, click. I need a door here, click. So that is how you can place your door. Now if you have a family, because if you check this door, they are really not cool. I don't like them, they are so boring actually. Now if I check in the visibility graphic, you see it looks so plain, they are so dull and boring. If you have external door which you can load that as well. But if you need external door, you can contact me, or you go to Revit City and get a door. But that is going to take you time for you to download and organize all those family. But I already downloaded and organized them, so if you want them, you can contact me and discuss on how you can get that. So if you want to load a door, external door, click on load family, it will take you to that, to another panel. Then you load your door. Now I have go back. Oh, did I keep this? Now we have, I'm looking for door, right? This is door. Click on door, and these are the doors that I have. And if you click in here, you have so many type of doors that you wish to load in. You have slide light, you have openings, you have garage door, you have double lift door, you have door handle. If you want to place a door handle, if you they have before door, you have single lift door, you have sliding door. And if you wish to customize your own door based on your own taste, you can do that. We're going to look into that in the future tutorial. That is going to be one of the advanced tutorial, how to make a door in Revit. So click on either of these. I think this is okay for me, or let me look at this. Or I will go back and look for another cool door. Now I have a, let me look for one here that is adorable, something like so. Yeah, click, you're going to load it. This is 2009 to 2018, but mind you, Revit never downgrade, it always upgrade. So if you have a version of family that is bigger, lower than yours, that is earlier than yours, it's not going to accept that. It only open a lower version, not a later version, except if they are of the same year. So pick this, and it's going to update. Now what happens if this is not the size of the door I want to put? How can I modify that? So you can see that my door is placed on natural ground level. There is no problem. I will fix that when we are done making an adjustment to this door. So if I should click on edit type on our properties panel, now the first thing you need to do is to make a duplicate. Never override the original element or a category or a family. Never override it. So you need to make a duplicate of that, then give it a name you wish to, or you leave it for Revit to give it a default name. But if you don't want a default name, you can type in the name in which you want. Click OK. Now scroll down this dimension. You have the width. If you want to alter the width, you can make it altered. Maybe you want to 1400 or 1500 or so, you can do that. That is 1.5 meters. You can also equally alter the height, which is 2.1, which is okay. You click yes, you see that my door has been altered, everything is been adjusted. So that is how you can make a modification on your door in case you want to make any adjustment to any door in Revit. That is how you can make an adjustment. Now I want to move all my door to level 2. Now like I said earlier, there are two ways in which you can make a selection. So I want to make a cross selection or a window selection, then filter, check none, pick doors, apply, okay. Then go and change the level from floor plan to head, sorry, from floor plan to, for natural ground level to floor plan, then apply. Now if you go to, if you check now, all your doors are well placed on your floor. So that is how you can place doors in Revit. So now next tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can place windows. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to give me a thumb up and share my videos to other people to have have this great knowledge. Thank you for